And we just reported to one of the 1 o'clock meeting about the police. We had a working group this morning. It followed on from the meeting last night, where one of the people facilitating invited the police to come on the platform and make a give some kind of report back. It was completely unnecessary, and a lot of people were concerned because, you know, the police have a very bad record in relation to people of color, younger people, homeless people, sex workers. So the decisions, the proposals and ideas from our working group this morning were that, one, the FIP, who are the advanced information gathering police, they've been on site taking pictures of people, and we want them completely off the camp. We don't want them here at all. The second point was that this is a peaceful camp, and it's here. We're here to stop major crimes by corporations and governments, so we don't need the police in our meetings or in the camp. The third point is that any requests from the police to come in should be filtered through, there's a committee that deals with that, so that if the police have a request, it's heard, but the police themselves don't have to come into the camp. People in the meeting this morning also described how at Dale Farm, which is a traveler's camp on the outside of London, as we speak now, the police are there evicting people, and they're travelers. They face a lot of discrimination. They've made a big struggle for about 10 years to keep their camp. Yesterday, the police were there tasering people. You know, and these are the same police who are policing the camp. Not far from here, about half a mile away, a man named Ian Tomlinson was killed. He was walking home completely, you know, not part of demonstration or anything. He was knocked down and killed by the police last year. A couple of months ago, Mark Duggan was shot down, killed by the police in Tottenham. There's still been no explanation of what happened, and in fact, the police lied about what happened. Young people, especially people of color, are being stopped and searched all over London, are being fitted up for crimes they haven't done. And for all those reasons, we just can't have the police in the camp, because those of us who are vulnerable will not feel safe. We also raise that people have to bear in mind, if they're having friendly conversations and chit-chatting with the police, that can put themselves and other people and the whole camp in danger.
There's no such thing as a little chat.
No such thing as an informal chat with the police. You know, they're here to gather information and to criminalize a whole set of people, and we just want all the camp to know that. Some people are aware and some people come here less aware. So part of our work as people of color is to convey that information to the people in the camp, to protect the camp, because we support it, because we're up against the wall in every way, including by the police. So that's what we were doing this morning. We're part of a network of women of color, and some of our colleagues are in the Occupy LA occupation. Others in our network are part of the prisoners' rights groups. We work with Mumia Abu-Jamal. We campaign to try to stop the horrible execution of Troy Davis, our brother, whose life they took in the most appalling way. So we're bringing our experiences in those struggles to this. When we speak about the police, we're drawing on those experiences. And our sisters in the U.S. are raising the same issues there that we're raising here. And we're also trying to make visible that the 99% is not only those of us here in Britain, but in other countries, Africa, India, Latin America. I mean, people who are struggling and working without wages, that is the real 99%. And we want to bring that, you know, people in Haiti, we want to bring all that into the occupation here so that we're stronger.